be rectified by receiving Jesus as our Savior. And once we've done that, we need to allow sozo, which is we've been saved, then we receive healing, and then what?
Wholeness.
And if we think we don't need any wholeness, we're in a blind cage.
Yes.
Or we're in a cage and we're blind. I love that God is constantly delivering me from my fears, constantly delivering me from the roots of oppression that goes so deep that I would not have seen them without submitting and surrendering to the Lord.
Amen.
Spirit of the devil is not going to help you in any way. The only thing that's going to help you is submission and surrender to the Lord. Those words are healthy when they are used in a healthy way. And they're words that are in Scripture. Amen. And I'm telling you right now that the root of anger is hurt. The root of anger is hurt. And if you feel anger that rises up in you quickly, it's because you haven't dealt with this unresolved hurt in your life. Have a life with the Lord. You spend time in prayer. You spend time in the presence of God. As you spend time in the presence of God and you surrender, you are able to let God in a healthy way bring healing into your enemy. And the more you resist that, the more you resist the wholeness that is yours. That's your inheritance, wholeness. And so we don't come into these meetings with this kind of thing, you know, we've got to do this. We're not into that. We've got to do what God has put. We have to be hot and ready. We don't come in here to warm up.
Yes.
Do you know what I'm saying?
Yes. Amen.
There's no time. I'm telling you people, there's no more time.
Yes, Lord.
You know what? If you're offended to someone, you're going to be honest with them. Not to pull them down, but because you care.
Yes.
Because you love them.
Yes.
So that they may be lifted up. Is that true?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. That's what the word says. Galatians 6:1. Go read it. The Lord wants an atmosphere of love and worship. Tonight we can make a decision, every one of us, whether that's what we want to do. We don't have to. We can walk out of here. We can be angry, we can be bitter, we can be whatever and still deny we are. And we can be the same and we have a choice. We don't have to do any of those things. But as you stand here before God, like before me, as you stand here before God tonight, decide what you want to do. Because God wants you to enter into a place of peace and restoration. Church to be restored, but how can a church be restored if the living bricks are not living?
Yeah, yeah.
Friends, I'm telling you, it's just God wants us to move in unity tonight, and there's a spirit of disunity breaking out some things in the spirit. That's why I'm holding on. That's why I haven't released this prayer. That's why I haven't finished.
Yes.
God wants to soften hearts tonight. And I'm telling you, this is a prophetic word. You all know that. This has been prophesied by people, pastors that come into this church, many. And many of you that have walked with me for many years will know this. You've seen it, you've even heard it. Why am I telling you this now? Because many of the prophetic words, including from several prophets, well-known, renowned prophets, have said that this is a prophetic intercessory work. And I'm telling you now that I'm prophesying to you that the day has come today.
Yes.
Now,
Hallelujah. We're in your time.
There's been a separation and the gift of prophecy has been released and unveiled in this church. Many of you are prophetic and God wants to use you. When you're facing the most opposition, it's because you're probably going to be used for the greatest thing in the kingdom of God than you can even imagine. And I want to increase your knowledge. Not in the things of the world, you can do that any time. I want to increase your knowledge. My job is to increase your knowledge in the things of the Spirit. My job is to bring you in to a place where you come to understanding. Paul said that people that do not have the Spirit do not understand the things of the Spirit. And he wasn't talking about just having an indwelling, he was talking about an infilling where there's a fusion between your spirit, soul, mind, body, everything.
Oh,
And the Lord has brought confirmation of this both from our leadership and from those outside this church who pre-prophesied this and didn't know. And I had no idea until the Lord put it all together for me in the last week or two. And then together with our leadership, our board of directors, along with other prophets in this nation, over the last 2 weeks as we were serving and giving to others, this came out. And tonight, in absolute agreement with my spirit, absolute peace with this church and with what God has set aside, and it's all fitting together now, I understand a word that you don't even know that I'm going to be speaking out tonight over your life.
Yes, amen.
That God gave me as a prophetic word to you when we first met. Because that is for now, and you're going to see how. Because tonight we are going to be ordaining Pastor Marietjie as the prophet of this church.
Amen.
She has always had a deep prophetic gift, always. But Pastor Marietjie is a very humble person, and the only time those that know her well that Pastor M gets really bold. Thank you, brother. Thank you. Is when she's under the anointing, right? How many know that?
Amen.
And I said to you a couple of weeks ago that when Pastor M talks, I stop and listen when it's in the spirit. And what God has been doing is increasing and increasing. And all of a sudden, there was an overwhelming initiation of that anointing by Holy Spirit in these last 2 weeks. It started when we were in Johannesburg. And all of a sudden, the Holy Spirit has just given Pastor M such a download that it's overflowing. We've had to get Pastor Tyus, our scribe, he just writes everything down. He knows exactly how to put it, where to put it. And just had to try and get everything down and record because there's just so much information, dates, names, places. How many here have already received word? Accurate word. Come on, put your hands up. Turn around and have a look at people. Put your hands up, front and back. Already, this is in 1 week. In 1 week, and the whole church is not here. In 1 week. Just words, dates, names, places, words of knowledge, prophetic words that cannot be from anywhere but the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
On Monday night, the Lord affirmed with our leaders and with me that Pastor Marietjie is to be appointed as a prophet for this church.
Yes.
And however that extends, that's fine. It doesn't mean other people don't prophesy, of course. People prophesy. There's a prophetic gift on this church, there's a prophetic mantle. But I understand the divine order now. Can you see how it's being set in place? Can you see? Apostle, prophet, evangelist, teacher, and pastor. See, there's a difference between office and functionality. Are you with me? You can still have the office of prophet, but Pastor M is Pastor M. She's the co-pastor. I don't have an office of apostle, but I'm still just a pastor. I'm a pastor. Amen? Are you with me? We'll do teachings on this. Don't worry if you say. So I want to ordain Pastor Marietjie as prophet. Prophet Marietjie Geldenhuys. That's why I'm laying hands on you. Because you are actually meant to be laying hands on as a prophet in the order of Melchizedek. Jeremiah 1:5. Before I formed you in the womb, I knew you. Before you were born, I set you apart. I appointed you as a prophet. Generations. And we've had lots of dreams that are prophetic, and we've just waited. And we've seen that so many of those things that we've seen in the spirit that it's impossible for us to do as humans. Even if we had lots of bugs, it's impossible some of the things we've dreamt and seen. But there's certain things we know are just on the wall. And we know that if it's done by God, that's the only way that could be done. So these things are of God. And so tonight we're going to appoint you as a prophet for this church, and a prophet for the nation, if the Lord wants a prophet for the nations. And I know that out of your mouth will be amazing things. Could you put on Isaiah 55 verses 8 to 12? I want to read this to you. Here's what the NIV says. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, neither are your ways my ways, declares the Lord. As the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways. I want you to listen to this word very carefully. And my thoughts higher than your thoughts. As the rain and the snow come down from heaven and do not return to it without watering the earth and making it bud and flourish, so that it yields seed for the sower and bread for the eater. I want you to say this with me. So is my word that goes out from my mouth. It will not return to me empty, but will accomplish what I desire and achieve the purpose for which I sent it. Now I've just read to you, so is my word, from that last section there. What I just read to you from Isaiah 55 was a word that I'd given Pastor M when we first met, that the Holy Spirit had given to me for her. I didn't understand the fullness of it, because sometimes the prophecy is just like that. But tonight I understand the fullness of it. So is my word that goes out from my mouth. It will not return to me empty, but will accomplish what I desire and achieve the purpose for which I sent it. What is this about? For Pastor M, this is about her being anointed as prophet, because that is exactly what she is here to bring. It's the word of the Lord, and it will not return empty because she has been called for such a time as this. The word of God will accomplish what it's called to accomplish and achieve the purpose for which it is sent, because you have been ordained to do what you've been called to do. That's why it will not go empty. When people are not called to do something and they try and be something they're not, even with the gifts, because they think it's fancy to be a prophet or a pastor. The anointing is never there. It's not strong, it's never there.
Yes.
But you know what? When the anointing is there, and when you're called, that word will never go void. And so I want to bring back to your mind this word that God gave you when we met. And I understand it now. It's the same one that says just after that, you will go out with joy and be led forth with peace, and the mountains and the hills will burst into song before you, and all the trees in the field will clap their hands. When you hear a word of prophecy, friends, there is something, there's a burst of joy. There's something inside of you that comes alive, because there's a resonance in your being which says, "Power, oh Lord, you cry out, Abba, you cry out, Abba." Because you understand that something inside of you is resonating with the word, because the word has come to life. It's an alive word, and it speaks life into you. Amen?
Amen.
Acts chapter 6, verse 6. Thank you. Read it with me. They presented these people to the apostles, who prayed and laid their hands on them. When we want to appoint and anoint and ordain someone, we lay hands on them as a significant public declaration, an act that we affirm who God has put in place. First called by God, and then anointed and appointed as per scripture. And then 1 Timothy 4:14, do not neglect your gift, which was given you through prophecy, when the body of elders laid their hands on you. You have seen the prophetic word in Isaiah 55, and I'm about to lay hands on you. And it's ironic because it's given through prophecy, and now it comes to the prophet who will reveal the will of God to this church, and so be it the nations. Can everybody say amen?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Come stand over here. And if any of you haven't had an encounter with Pastor Eddie, and experience what's been going on in the last few weeks, and how the Lord has been using her. So now Pastor Marietjie Geldenhuys . The time has come for the Lord to set you apart, according to Jeremiah 1:5 and according to Isaiah 55. I know this responsibility is a big weight, especially when you're a prophet. I understand what comes with this, and I recognize that there are going to be times of travailing, and it's going to be difficult, and I think you already know that. But you know what? Whom the Lord has set apart, we cannot. It's course of who you are, it's the course of your destiny. And no longer can the enemy hold you back from your called purpose on this level. It's not that you haven't fulfilled on every other level, but this is the new level that the Lord is taking you to. Amen. So in the company of this congregation and our leaders, I want to officially right now, by the laying on of hands according to Acts 6:6 and 1 Timothy 14:4, I want to lay hands on you and appoint you as prophet right now, designated and called by God, and approved and anointed by those surrounding you now, your leaders, and me as your pastor.
Showed me scripture, and it's exactly about the seas. tends to the brightness of your dawn. Then you will look and be radiant, your heart will throb and swell with joy. The wealth on the seas will be brought to you, and to you the riches of the nations will come.
That's what promises the wealth on the seas. Verse 5 of Isaiah 16. And the Lord's been telling us, arise, amen, come friends, lift your hands up.